Cohort 1 students have been the easiest, nicest people to work with. I was new to the department when I started working with them, and they couldn't have been more understanding about this being the first cohort and working out all the bugs and making everything be a smooth transition. They are all going to do wonderful, fabulous things in the future.
Well, congratulations to everybody. Congratulations on finishing your doctoral program and for persevering for 3 long years. I've certainly enjoyed getting to know all of you, but I'm also looking forward to having all of you go out there in the world of work and not have to look at your papers any longer. And it's come up a number of times about a magic box I have that is kind of a bottomless collection of journal articles. I pull that out for each of the cohorts and had an opportunity to try it out on you guys first. And sure enough, it worked.
Okay, this has been an awesome experience working with Cohort 1. This is something I've been looking forward to for a decade. That's how long it's been. And to realize this dream of having a doctoral program was very special, but even more special was this the first cohort. How many times have I said awesome today? Okay, several times. It's a new word I picked up over the last 2 years. Maybe it was from one of the students. Is that 30 seconds?
First of all, warmest congratulations to all of the members of Cohort 1. I'm very proud of each and every one of you who have made it to this point. I have very, very fond memories of Cohort 1 because obviously you were the first one, and I, along with Dr. Borba, had the opportunity to work with you your very first semester of the program. I hope that you don't have bad memories of that first opportunity to spend time with me. I know it wasn't perfect, but I'm glad that you were willing to work with me as we kind of maneuvered some of the rough spots in there. I wish all of you very, very well in your future endeavors, and I'm really glad to have been even just a small part in what you will bring to the future of education.
One of the most telling moments for me was when we had just finished our first two classes. We were still reeling from Dr. Poole's final, and we were in Dr. Borba's class. We were so excited about a 2-week break. Dr. Riggs walked in and handed us the reading assignment for our next class, which was going to occur in 2 weeks. So we no longer had the 2-week break. At that point, Frank, who was sitting in front of me, turned around, leaned back and said, "I wouldn't tell your husband about this." That happened every class. So every time we thought we were gonna get a break, we didn't. But we learned so much, and we didn't tell our significant others, and we appreciate all the support that they gave us through this program.
If there's anything I take away from this program, it is the idea that I can think in so many different ways as a result of all the lessons and all the topics that we've covered. And for that, I'm eternally grateful.
Hi, what I remember about the program is our first day coming in and actually taking that test and just seeing who everybody in the cohort was, and then also Dr. Borba's ties for his videos that he did for the first semester. So that's what I remember.
Sitting in the room the first time when we met as a cohort and getting the orientation, and I realized I was representing preschool for the entire program, and I was happy to do it, and I've learned a lot from the rest of my cohort.
Hello. Wow, it seems like just yesterday that we were in Dr. Poole's class, Bonferroni, as Steve puts it, and here we are, last semester of school. I'm really excited. Thank you to all the professors. Have a great summer. Bye.
Okay, so I've been trying to think of what I was going to say, and the one thing that stands out in my mind was sitting on the floor of Dr. Riggs' summer class, 9 months pregnant, because I couldn't get comfortable, and getting up and down, and everybody looking at me and worrying that I was going to go into labor. that night. So it's been fun, and Cohort 1, I'm going to miss you, and good night.
I can't believe it's already been 3 years since we started this. I remember very first time we started going and got going in statistics, and that if it hadn't been for Deborah Tavernier coming to help me in the library, I would have never made it. And so thank you, Deborah, and thank you for all the professors that have contributed to our education over the last 3 years.
The memories that I'll take away are from the first semester when we had Dr. Borba, and he told us that as educational leaders that we need to examine what we're doing in education, and if it's not working, then why are we doing it? So that was something I'll definitely always keep with me. And the other thing is how proud I am of myself for getting an A- in Dr. Poole's class.
I have some very memorable experiences here in the doctoral program. One of them in particular being the quality of the staff. The faculty was wonderful, very supportive. I'll never forget Dr. Borba, of course, Dr. Poole, Dr. Riggs. We had some quality instructors. Another experience that I'll never forget, and I think this is where it really sunk in that I was a doctoral student and I was going to finish this, was when we passed that writing exam. When we got our results that we passed the writing exam, that was definitely a most memorable experience. And I can definitely say that now after 2.5-3 years, my Tahoe has over 100,000 miles. Thank you to the program.
All right, so the first thing I want to point out is that it's 9 o'clock at night and we just got out of class. Why? Because we stay the whole time. This program is for real. Fortunately, it's not 10 like it was our first semester. So, gotta tell my favorite story from the whole program. The very first semester, we finished our first set of classes and we got all the way through December, and the very last night, we're thinking, oh, we've made it. We got through finals, we turned everything in, it's almost Christmas break, and we're gonna have free time, which hasn't happened in months, literally since we started. So we're finishing up class, and we're almost free, and just before the end, here comes Dr. Riggs, and he has a box. And I think the box was bigger than Dr. Riggs. He must have had to drag it in because it was ridiculous. So he starts taking out handouts and articles. And there's more paper and more paper and more paper, and it's never ending. And we honestly thought the box was empty. And then he turns and reaches in and hands out more paper. It's literally never ending. So we learned Dr. Riggs doesn't mess around. He's serious with the photocopies. There is no break in the EdD program. Even when you think it's winter break, it's not winter break because you have homework. Whether you like it or not, you should be reading something at all times. So the never-ending box, definitely with Dr. Riggs, is one of my favorite and funniest memories of the program, just because it was so unbelievable and it set the tone for what we were up to. If that first semester hadn't already, we definitely knew at the end what we were in for. But I don't know, thinking about getting to the end now, definitely owe big thank yous to the faculty and the rest of my classmates in Cohort 1, because I wouldn't be here without everybody else. Definitely a group effort to get to the end now, and looking back at that first semester, I had no idea what we were in for, but I am so glad I was a part of it, and I feel like I'm really lucky to have been able to do it and to get to know everybody. So thank you to my classmates and to our faculty.
I just wanted to thank everybody in the program, especially my colleagues and all the professors. It's been a really nice journey, and I couldn't have done it alone. So thank you to everybody in this cohort and all the professors for making it.
My most memorable memories are the nights that Frank and I spent on the phone. We spent more time together over the phone on Sunday evenings than we actually spent with our spouses the first year and a half of this program. I won't forget that, Frank. Thanks for being there for me. And then, what can I say? I'll never forget scopophilia in our critical pedagogy class, and the food, and the good friends, and the support.
I just want to say thank you to everybody. It's been fun. It's been great. It's been a quick 3 years. When we first started, we thought we would never quit, and now we're here towards the end. I hope everybody does good, and I'll see you guys all at graduation. Good night.
Okay, 19 years of consecutive enrollment at California State University Stanislaus, and I have to say, I'm a little bit sad to say goodbye.
When I came into this program, I wanted to have an experience with the best professionals in the Valley, talking about education, What I got was so much more. Wonderful colleagues, wonderful professors. We had babies born, dreams realized. Cohort 1 is the best. We'll always be number 1. So thank you guys.
I'm very honored to be a part of this program and be part of the first cohort to go through as a graduating class. And I enjoyed the most the collaboration with everybody and the partnerships that grew amongst us. The thing I remember the most is Dr. Borba's dancing, and I'll never forget that. So thank you for dancing for us, Dr. Borba.
Well, I'm Steve Charbonneau, and probably the most interesting memory to me is we have a precious lady named Lula in the program, and early on she said, Steve, I like you, because you talk a lot. And then I reflected and I said, boy, I must really talk a lot. And recently, I'm proud to say, I met a girl from the second cohort, this very last class, and she said, Steve, according to your reputation, I thought you would have spoken a lot more in class. So I felt that that's probably the most legitimate thing I learned in the doctoral program. Don't talk so much. Thank you.
Through the program, there was a point of time where I felt I'm going to quit, and that was really a nerve-wracking for me, which is midpoint in the program when we had the written qualifying exam. However, it went well, and I'm glad I sticked with the program, and I really would like to thank all the professors, Dr. Riggs in specific, my chair. I'm glad that I chose CSU STEM to be my graduate school of choice.
My favorite memory is of eating olives and other snacks at Connie's Tate's house while we griped and groaned about how hard our lives were. Actually, we weren't that bad off and we had a lot of fun. That's what I remember the most.
Probably one of the things that I remember most would be class after 9:30 every day and having trouble trying to focus my brain and listen and have educated discussions past 9:30. That would probably be one of the things I remember most. Very difficult. Also, all just remembering all the friendships and all the relationships that we made in Cohort 1 that we'll have forever. It's awesome.
My favorite memory is trying to cram in my dissertation project into all the classwork and spending hours at Connie's house, putting our presentations together, reviewing the projects, and just watching my weekends go by.
Hello, I'm Martha, and I wanted to share with you my story about being in the program. My memorable moment is, of course, that every time we had to do a presentation, everybody wanted to go after Steve, because Steve wanted to always go first, and nobody felt comfortable following him. So Steve, we're still following you.
My name is Margaret, and I think the best thing for me that I got from the program was listening to speakers who came from the field of community college. It was great, and I really learned a lot from those people. And I want to say thank you to my colleagues, Mother, Steve, and everybody who's been very helpful to me. Thank you.
Hi, this is Debbie Tavernier, and I have a few moments. They were both in the first semester, and it was Borba babbles. We had to go home and listen on our computer to Borba talking to area leaders, and I ended up calling it Borba babbles, kindly. The other memory I have is the styrofoam cups. And we would put the styrofoam cup on top of our computer screen when we needed help in stats. The class that nearly killed us all, but we made it.
Well, I do have this one memory of coming to class and then being accosted by this rather tall person with a camera asking me for memories. So I think I'll always remember that.
Well, here's my story, and it's about what happens away from the class. I have camped out at my home in the reading room in a particular chair for the last 3 years. And during the qualifying exams, what happened is we actually played it up to the hilt, my family and I. We put caution tape around the chair, and they just slid in the food during the 72-hour period, and I ate and did everything in the chair and completed my qualifying exam. So that's the indelible memory that I'll have of the doctoral program at CSU Stanislaus.
Okay, Steve Graham here. Almost the last night of the EdD program, and I got a story to tell you. This is the one that really was my disorienting experience. Back when we were in the quantitative statistics course with Dr. Poole, it was quite interesting that we had a take-home exam, which was great. We were all like, awesome, take-home exam. Only problem was Dr. Poole scared the crap out of us. How do you scare the crap out of somebody with a take-home exam? Well, she did it. What we had to do was we had to actually sign a waiver telling that we would not disclose or discuss or do anything with this take-home exam with anybody. And then if we did, there would be severe consequences like being dropped out of the program, prosecuted, first baby and all that good stuff. So Dr. Poole, you scared the crap out of me then and you're still staring the crap out of me now. But I want to thank you for being on the committee. All your great work, Dr. Borba, Borba Speaks, loved that, it was awesome. Dr. Riggs with his magical box, and just all my professors that we had were just tremendous, outstanding. And obviously the classmates, I can honestly say that I'm really, really close to a lot of classmates, and I'm gonna miss you guys. So hopefully we'll be able to connect in the future as doctors. Just call me Dr. G.
Right. California State University. They have successfully completed all of the requirements specified by the College of Education and have been recommended by the faculty to be awarded the doctorate, master's, and baccalaureate degrees.
Dr. Steve Charbonneau. Dr. Heather Ann Contreras. Dr. Luna Hassan Abusali. Dr. Stephanie Jennifer Alvarez. Dr. Laura Ann Lembo. Dr. Cynthia Joy Lopez. Dr. Constance Jane Tate. Dr. Lisa Heron.
Yes.
Kay Vang. Doctor. Dr. Christina Hoffman Brown. Dr. Lena Moa. Dr. Deborah Lynn Tavernier. Dr. Adrena Alkas. Dr. Michelle Pimentel. Dr. Christina Garcia. Dr. Margaret Kingery. Dr. Donald Jordan. Dr. Stephen Douglas Graham. Dr. Stephen Edwin Gomes. Dr. Danielle Julia Wake.